Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here, New Life Pentecostal Church, Albany, Georgia. Hope you're having a great day in Jesus. I just want to, you know, sit around and reminisce sometimes. I want to tell you about when the dean of theology, basically, at Harvard University got the baptism of the Holy Ghost, speaking in other tongues. His name was George Hunston Williams, and he was the Hollis Chair of Divinity, which in times in America was considered the preeminent chair of divinity or the preeminent professorship in the entire United States of America. So, what had happened, and I heard this from Denver Stanford. Now, I always want to qualify my stories with this. When I say stories, I mean, these are true biographical things, but I'm repeating things that I was told and heard years ago. So if somebody knows better, truthfully, not trying to defend something and makes up lies and hagiography and all this, but if somebody truthfully knows better, put something in the comments, make a YouTube video, send an email, and we'll clarify. But this is what was told me, okay? Denver Stanford went and started a church in Boston, Massachusetts, and I do remember that. And like Eli and Kathy Hernandez came out of that church. Kathy did, anyhow. Great saxophonist. And so, Brother Stanford had several students that were at Harvard. And so they came to Brother Stanford one day and said, "Our professor wants to meet you." And so he said, "Okay, let's meet." So Brother Stanford said, he walked in there, and Brother Stanford passed away not long ago, but this needs to be recorded. It's part of the Pentecostal story, that these things happened, and that it was true stories, biography. And so Brother Stanford goes to meet with George Hunston Williams. Now, many people think George Hunston Williams at the time was the leading theologian in the world, but no doubt he was one of the leading theologians in the world. And Brother Stanford said he deeply lived his faith. Like he wanted to walk, take public transportation and all this. Protecting the environment and all this. And so he began to talk to Brother Stanford. And so then he asked Brother Stanford, he said, "What do you believe?" Now, Brother Stanford, you know, he had pastored in Kansas before this. He had some of the most unique testimonies. Like within a year of each other, he had two different people drop dead in his church services, like on a Sunday night. I think it may be Morrill Cornwell's church that he pastors now, is where Brother Stanford used to pastor. So Brother Stanford said, here he was intimidated by this guy, PhD, Union Theological Seminary, but he's like, now he's asking me about the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and now he's on my territory because he doesn't know about it. So Brother Stanford began to explain to him about the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and George Hunston Williams says, "I want that." And so there came a point in time, now this would have been in the late 70s, early 80s, that time before cell phones and all of this, that one of the students called Brother Stanford and said, "George Hunston Williams is in the chapel at Harvard University, and we're praying for him. He's seeking the Holy Ghost." So Brother Stanford goes to get down there, and George Hunston Williams got the baptism of the Holy Ghost, speaking in other tongues. And he was a changed man. And according to Brother Stanford, he went home and he was so excited, he told his wife that he got the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And they said the next morning his wife was vacuuming in their house. And she was saying to herself, "I wish I could get the baptism of the Holy Ghost. God probably wouldn't fill somebody like me with the Holy Ghost. The baptism of the Holy Ghost is for other people, just not like me." And before she knew it, she found herself sprawled out on the carpet, speaking in other tongues, because God had filled the chair of theology at Harvard University's wife with the baptism of the Holy Ghost as well. And so he wrote books about the Radical Reformation and so many different things, and basically and led the 1982 Harvard Symposium on Oneness Pentecostalism, and along with so many others came to the conclusion that we were pre-Nicene Christianity and really original New Testament Christianity. God wants everybody to get the Holy Ghost. If the dean of theology, so to speak, or this chair of theology at Harvard can get the Holy Ghost, if his wife can get the Holy Ghost, you can get the Holy Ghost too. So that's when the dean of theology at Harvard University got the Holy Ghost. I wish I could fill in more blanks, but I think it's important to keep those realities alive. God bless. I love you in Jesus' name.